Seniors, or should I say, graduates, tonight is your night. Tonight, you have graduated, and from here on out, no more high school. No more high school classes, no more high school teachers, and no more high school homework. A great responsibility is over and has been lifted off of your shoulders, yet it is now to be replaced by an even heftier responsibility, that of the future, near and far. But what goals have you set for your future? Martin Luther King once said in an address, "I have a dream," but that was not what he was really saying. His actions rather said for him, "I have a goal, a definite future in mind, and not just a dream." You see, a dream is merely fantasy, whereas a goal is something that's actually tangible. A dream you cannot actually control, whereas a goal, you may lead its path. Mr. King had a dream, but he made it into a life goal so that he could do something for it. Dreams are what have propelled mankind, but only after they've become goals. Now, you've got to realize that once you set this goal, that you're going to have to work for it. One of the things which differentiates goals from dreams is that with goals, there are things that you, as individuals, can do to work towards its completion. But in working for a goal, there's always a right way and a wrong way. A good illustration of this involves something that happened to me just yesterday. How many of you seniors or graduates know what one of these are? Yes, it is a speeding citation. One of my goals yesterday was to get from point A to point B. Unfortunately, due to some prior commitments, I was running a little bit late. Now, instead of taking the right way and letting myself get there a little late, I wanted to try to make it on time. So I went a little bit faster than the legal speed limit would like to allow, and as a result, not only the $50, but I was even later than I would have been if I had taken my time. Now there is so much, though, that someone can learn from something as simple as this, and quite simply, it's that there's a right way and there's a wrong way to achieve your goals. The right way involves hard work, time, and much effort. Whereas the wrong way, even though it might seem easier and even quicker at the time, usually, if not always, ends up in ruin. So tonight, the choice is yours. First, in choosing your goal, and then in achieving it in the correct manner. Just let me leave you with one question that each of you must decide to answer at some point of time during your life. What is it in your life that will cause one person, yourself, to make an impact on this world now populated with nearly 5 billion people? What are you going to make of your life that will affect such a number of people? Because I believe that Each and every one of you has the ability, as well as the opportunity, to make something out of your life. What, may I ask, will that be? So dream on always, and grasp that beautiful image of whatever you're dreaming about, and then change it and make it a goal, and work for it. And I know that you will truly achieve that which you dedicate yourself to. Graduates and friends, for all the good memories, thank you.
Welcome will not end, though it's hard to let you go, But in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. Friends are friends forever if the Lord's the Lord of them. And a friend will not say never, 'cause the welcome will not end. So it's hard to let you go, but in the Father's hands we know that a lifetime's not too long to live as friends. No, a lifetime's not too long to live as friends.
I'd like to say a personal thing to the class of 84 before I get started on my speech tonight. It's been my pleasure, my privilege to work with you over the past few years. If I have any regrets, my only regret is I haven't had a chance to work with each and every one of you. Tonight begins a new era in your lives. I know many of you are unhappy with the way your life has been up to this point. I know many of you are disappointed in your achievements or your lack of achievements. But tonight is one of the few times in your life, it'll be the only time that the class of 84 as a group will have a chance to change your life. Decision is yours. You can take your life and you can do something worthwhile with it, or you can take your life and you can throw it away. Only you can make that decision. You know, we live in the land of opportunity. And if you don't believe me that there's opportunities in this country, you just ask the hundreds of thousands of people who emigrate to this country every year. And they'll tell you the reason why they come here is because they have the opportunity to change their lives, to make their lives better. You as a group, the class of 84, are looking at that opportunity. No one can live in the past. No one is going to be interested in what you did last week, last month, last year. No one is interested in what your class rank is going to be. No one's interested in how many points you scored in the last basketball game. No one's interested in how many days you spent in the ISS room. The world is interested in today, what you can do now. You're all starting with a clean slate. You have the opportunity to change your life if you dare to take that chance. You can change your life for better, or you can change your life for worse. You might say, can it be done? And I can say, yes, I've seen it done. I've seen students leave here with very mediocre academic records. I've seen students leave here who were in trouble all the time, spent more time on suspension than they did in class. And yet they went away to college, they went into the army, they took a job, and they got somewhere where no one knew their past history, where no one knew their past record, and they grabbed at the opportunity to change their lives, and they excelled. You can take your life and you can do something worthwhile with it, or you can take your life and you can throw it away. I've seen students, as a matter of fact, one of them, just recently, I got a card from one of those students who graduated with his doctorate degree in freshwater ecology, a student who had a very mediocre record, but he took the challenge and he met the challenge. I've also seen students who are academically excellent, who are leaders in their class, who are stars on the athletic field, who have gone away from here, wasted their time, wasted their lives, wasted their money. One who was very close to me, a fellow I went to grade school with, captain of the football team, top 10% of his class, had everything going for him, died of a heroin overdose his senior year. You can take your life and you can do something with it. Or you can take your life and you can throw it away. Only you can do it. Well, how can you change your life? One of the biggest problems people your age face every day is the fact that you have low self-esteem for yourselves. You don't believe in yourselves. You got to start with a positive attitude about yourself. Every person in this auditorium has good qualities. Every person in this auditorium has bad qualities. Nobody's perfect. But what you have to do is you have to work on those good qualities. You got to maximize them. You've got to minimize those bad qualities. But most of all, you got to believe in yourself. I get tired of hearing people run themselves down. Don't you know there's a whole group of people out there that'll do that job for you? Don't take their job away from them. What you have to do is you have to look for the inner beauty in all people. Surface beauty is nice. Physical beauty is nice, but it's transitory. It fades with age. The inner beauty in all men, the thing that lasts forever. Don't be afraid to make mistakes. Einstein failed grade school mathematics. How do you know you can't do something unless you try? We all learn by making mistakes. It's being smart enough not to repeat that same mistake over and over and over again. And the last thing you should do is you should pursue a career that you enjoy. Be it a homemaker, mechanic, brain surgeon, or poet. If you don't enjoy what you're doing, you're going to be miserable. One of my college roommates had an opportunity to go to work for IBM. It was the job he wanted. It was everything he wanted to do. But he made one error. It didn't pay enough money. So he took a job with Union Carbide. And for the next 2 years, he was the most miserable person you'd ever want to meet. He detested getting up and going to work every morning until he finally realized that he was wasting his life. He quit, joined IBM, and is a happy man. You can do something with your life that's worthwhile, or you can throw it away. No one can do it for you. You know, the people that love you the most, the people who have made sacrifices for you, and they've made a lot of sacrifices for you. You may not know how many sacrifices they made. Those people sitting behind you here in this auditorium have done the best they can for you. They can't do any more. All they can do now is give you encouragement. It's up to you. Don't be like Mark Twain, who once said, "When I was 16, I was ashamed at how ignorant my father was. And when I got to be 21, I was amazed at how much the old man had learned in 5 years. You know, like Twain, some of you are going to learn to appreciate the efforts and sacrifices your parents have made for you. Don't wait too long to tell them how you feel. But better yet, why don't you do something worthwhile with your life? Don't throw them away. But remember, the decision is yours."
Memories. Memories of high school last our whole life long. Memories that we sing with our song. Our special friendships and times we've shared make leaving harder for us to bear. The thoughts of new friendships doesn't ease the pain. It just lets us know that nothing can be the same. Thoughts of a new start remind us of the past. The time we made new friends, and the time we will again. Loves that once were fade into the past, because as time goes on, nothing seems to last. All that's left are the memories. Knowledge that you've gained over the years can't stop the love-stained tears. They come from your eyes with each heartfelt goodbye. Your mind will keep all these times, tied with a wide ribbon of joy. Here's to us, the class of 84. May our memories live forever.
Watercolor memory. The students to be presented tonight comprise the graduates of the class of 1984. These students have met the requirements set forth by School District 205. Mr. Miller?
On behalf of the community and the Board of Education, I feel privileged to have the opportunity to offer congratulations to the graduates and to say to them we're proud. I would like to offer our admiration to the parents and teachers and a sincere thank you to taxpayers. I would ask Mr. Owens then to please call the roll of the class so they may be publicly recognized by the community. Mr. Owens.
Thank you, Mr. Miller. One last note as the marshals come forward. Parents, grandparents, aunts, uncles, brothers, sisters, and you seniors, there are 370 young people to recognize this evening. We don't want to rush through this, but we do want to keep it moving. We would appreciate no individual recognition. We know you're all proud of each individual, but it would slow us down. We'd like to start now, so thank you. Rebecca Lynn Sward. Aaron Patrick Stover. Felicia Renee Sprague. Penny Lorraine Davis. Catherine Ann Bent. Joel William Abramson. James Knowles Adams. Tracy Joe Aldridge. Julie Lynn Alexander. Joy Lynn Allen. Eric Ronald Anderson. Randall Dean Anderson. Michael Allen Armstrong. Donna Sue Austin. Brian Keith Bailey. Michael Jack Ball. Lynn Marie Ballinger. Stephen M. Bant. Stephen Michael Batzer. Robert L. Boffman. Kelly Ann Hicks. Stephen Dale Clark. Dawn Michelle Shane. Robert Quentin Johnson. Jeffrey William Bergendine. Brenda Beth Bird. Marna Jean Blakewell. Mitchell Ray Bledsoe. Douglas Allen Blucker. Patty Joe Bodenhammer. Anne Marie Both. Tammy Sue Booth. Dale Allen Borth. Greta Ann Bowman. Melinda Ray Bowton. Deanne Lynette Brannon. Karen Joy Bray. Peter Ned Brown. Todd Stephen Brewington. Robert Sean Buck. Pamela Suzanne Burton. John William Johnson. Donna Elaine Bullock. Charles R. Burgess. David E. Bush. Stacy Sue Butkovich. Roger Eugene Butts. Patricia Ann Campbell. Eric Joseph Carlson. Matthew Reed Carlson. Paul Carlson Jr. Scott Douglas Carlson. Timothy Charles Carlson. Tracy Lynn Martinez Cervantes. Jeffrey Ray Cervantes. Lisa Roxanne Chanley. Suzanne Elizabeth Chandler. Sherry Lynn Cheney. Nancy Chin. Lisa Marie Christensen. Lori Ann Christensen. Sylvia Cipriani. Mark Philip Sermatic. Kimberly Carmel Clays. Jerry Lee Clark. Kimberly Joe Clark. Michael Colin Coffey. Bradley Eugene Coleman. Michelle Diane Connors. Michael John Cooley. Bryce Malcolm Kuhn. Kelly Jo Kuhn. Rhonda Gail Cordell. Ralph Navasca Corpus. Jill Eileen Craig. Sarah Lynn Kroos. Lori Deanne Dagan. Timothy Edward Glass. Janet Sue Davidson. Robert Davies. Donna Michelle Davis. Catherine Christine Davis. Randy H. Davis. Keith T. Delk. Julie Diane Gao. Denise Diane Dennis. Jeffrey Dennis. Maida Dioris. Valerie Dickerson. Melody Grace Dillon. Joseph Raymond Droke. Sally Ann Duval. Diane Lisa Easley. Anna Maria Echeverry. Rhonda Jane Eklund. Graydon Eugene Elledge. Deborah Arlene Elliott. Samuel Todd Erickson. Troy Walden Ewing. Christopher Allen Farrar. David Michael Farrell.
Fowler, right?
David Allen Fowler. Richard Lee Fielder.
Colleen.
Elizabeth Colleen Fields. Jamie Renee Fisher. Emily Gail Fitch. Judith May Fitzpatrick. Lonnie Rashawn Florence. Lynette Louise Frost. Dana Renee Francois. Brian Kenneth Fry. Anne Marie Gagg. Irish Lee Gardner.
Dava Nicole Godeke.
Dava Nicole Godeke. Lisa Diane Guai. Michelle Marie Graham. Pamela Marie Gunther. Christopher Macklin Gunderson. Robert D. Haynes. Julianne Hall. Lori Sue Hall. Tim E. Hampsch. Sandra Josephine Jennings. Bitten Ann Jensen. Bobby Leo Carr Johnson Jr. Christina Louise Hammerlin. Colleen Ann Hannigan. Tricia Lynn Hannigan. Sandra Jean Hannum. Lori Ann Harding. Renee Lynn Harding. Tracy Lynn Hare. Becky Jo Harler. Brad E. Harms. Deborah Ray Harris. Diane Ray Harris. Pamela K. Harris. Rebecca Lynn Harris. Michelle Ann Hart. James Jeffrey Hallworth. Lenore M. Hayes. Melissa Sue Heck. Rachel Elizabeth Hellinga. Greg Lee Heller. Stacy Ann Hendricks. Patricia Charlene Hensley. Dale F. Herschelman. Tony Renee Hevlin. Donald Hickey.
Hebert.
Mark Allen Hebert.
Hilgenberg.
Jeffrey Thomas Hilgenberg. Donovan Hilligoss. Deborah Jo Hodges. Jody Lynn Holloway. Ann Christine Holt. Patrick Joel Haraney. Noel Virginia Huff. Patrick Wade Huffaker. Jeffrey Dean Hughes. Wendy Jean Hughes. Robert Troy Holsizer. Sean David Herr. Mel E. Indelicato. Okay. Elizabeth Lorraine Ennis. Carlos Gerard Interior. Henry Interior. Michelle Lynette Jackson. Deborah Ann James. Karen Lee Johnson. James Lewis Johnson, Jr. Catherine Lee Johnson. Linda Sue Johnson. Preston E. Johnson. Raymond Lee Johnson. Susan Marie Johnston. Todd Lee Jones. John E. Camano. Michael Lawrence Kennedy. Elizabeth Ann Nelson. Stephen Dean Nelson. Christopher Scott Kent.
Kieser, right?
Paul David Kieser, Jr. Paula K. Kessel. Hold up. Kim Leslie Kessler. John Walter King. Lori Marisa Kistler. Chris Eileen Klein. Marcia Ellen Klemke. John Patrick Niss. Patrick Benjamin Knox. Crystal Ruth Knuth. Kimberly Ann Kostalecki. Julie Alexandria Lakus. Wendy Lee Lawrence. Christine Annette Lee. Craig W. Lee. Mark D. Lester.
Hold up.
Scott Lee, Joshua Linnell. Anthony D. Logan. Gus Allen Lowry. Jeffrey James Luna. Teresa Ann Luna. Lori Ann Magnuson. Sarah Jane Mahoney. Karen Diane Malloy. Tracy K. Mattson. Joseph Vincent Maxwell. Stephen George McNeil. Michael W. McVeigh. Nancy Eleanor Mears. Becky Jane Moline. Rana Leanne Metz. Kelly Ann Milan. Julie Joanne Miller. Doris Lavette Mitchell. Russell Edward Mitchell. Stacia Lynn Mitchell. Tina Marie Mitchell. Candace Jo Morgan. Daniel Joseph Morrison Jr. Larry Dean Morrison. J. Lee Mulvey. Jody Lynn Murphy. Anita Gail Myrick. Melissa Carol Nagel. Mary Ann Nemeth. Frederick Edward Nichols. Clyde Dwayne Norris Jr. James Franklin Norris. Jonathan Dean Nystrom. John Edward Oakley. Melody Lane Oaks. Matthew Thomas O'Byrne. Leslie Lou Odell. Cynthia Yvonne Smith. April Denise Olson. Michael Raymond Owens. Richard Anthony Padilla. Brian C. Page. Paul Vincent Palmer. Donald William Patterson. Teresa Louise Patterson. John Nelson Peck.
Ronaldo Sayo Perez.
Ronaldo Sayo Perez. Dawn Elizabeth Perkins. Curtis Paul Pershnick. Rodney Neil Peters. Michael Ray Peterson. Teresa Marie Peterson. Scott William Phillipson. Kevin Ray Pickrell. Marsha Luann Pickrell. James William Pinkham. Lisa Marie Poplett Bush. Douglas Lee Powell. Trenton L. Rader. Bridget Catherine Ralston. Lori Ann Ralston. Michael Glenn Reed. David Scott Rickard. Anne Marie Riggert. Okay. We've done real well. Everyone deserves the same opportunity. Rhonda K. Riley. Cynthia Diane Roach. Michael David Rhodes. Deborah Lee Roberts. John T. Rogers. Sally Ann Roth. Tina Marie Roth.
Russell.
Leslie Denise Russell. Mary Beth Russell. Sherry K. Rutzert. Sharon Melinda Sage. Tara Elizabeth Sandborg. Marcella Sue Scott. Jane Sillette. Lori Ann Shirk.
Warm up here, buddy. What are you sweating for?
David Todd Shoemaker. James R. Skillman. Teresa Ann Sloan. Carol Lynn Smith. Carol Suzanne Smith. Charles Lee Smith. Mark Eugene Smith. Amy Michelle Smurs. David James Snyder. Tina Marie Southard. Kimberly M. Sparks. Jonathan Lawrence Springer. Ricky E. Steele. Timothy Lee Stevenson. Angela C. Stone. Kevin Brett Stone. William Gerard Struck. Elizabeth Ann Suter. James Michael Suter. Laura Eileen Swadley.
Penny Sue Swanson. Douglas Dean Sweeborg. Ian Todd Simmons. Janet K. Tasker. Willie C. Terry Jr. Bradley E. Theobald. Byron John Theory. James H. Thompson. Rita Lynn Tien. Elizabeth Ann Torlentis. Kenneth Larry Tracy. Janice Marie Treadway. James Thomas Tressel. Anna Marie Trone. Hold up there. Gregory Lee Turner. Jill Christine Turney. Robert D. Van Beveren. Denise L. Van Osdall. Adam Jess Vega. Alice Vega. Douglas Scott Villardo. Michael Terrence Bowler. Jeffrey Ray Von Drake. Stephen Scott Wager. Paul Leon Wallenfeld. Rebecca K. Walters. George Leroy Waugh III. Judith A. Waddell. Shelley Renee Weiss. Sean Michael Wiegan. William Carl Wendland. Lavana Renee Worth. Monroe Curtis White. Catherine Joyce Wiesner. Becky Jo Williams. Jeffrey Wayne Williams. Brian James Williamson. Carolyn Jean Wilson. Denise Ann Wilson. Melissa Ann Wilson. Sherry Lee Wilson. Deborah Wintery. Thomas Gene Warden, Jr. Shelley Ann Werkheiser. Rodney Carl Wright. Marcia Ann Mundy Yeast. John Wesley Young. Ellen Lee Zook.
On behalf of the school administration, you've been an excellent group. We've enjoyed you. Class of 1984, to signify your accomplishment of graduation from GHS, move your tassel from the left to the right. Congratulations. Now, Pastor Christian.
Bow your hearts unto God and receive the benediction. Almighty God, the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit, bless these special young men and women as they go from here to new challenges, new joys, and new promise. Empower them to reflect the light of your love and compassion to those whose lives will meet theirs. Make them instruments of your peace, now and forever. Amen.